There'll be some skaters out here who will be wanting to prove that they were better than the short program, who'll want to be getting up higher than they were, like the American Michael Weiss and Zagorodnyok, and the skating tonight is just going to be the best. Difficult to get in the stadium tonight.
Yeah, that's one of the understatements. Even though you've got passes, they do things a bit differently here, but anyway, we're here. Look, if you had to pick one out of the top four, I know it's a tough question, but Kulik, Yagodin, the two Russians, Todd Eldridge, who's been in superb form, and Elvis Stoyko. Who would you pick? I mean, what is the requirement? Is it mental toughness that's needed tonight?
They have to land everything. It is going to be the perfect performance that wins tonight, and that's what we're after. Hard to go past Elvis.
All right, well, stay with us, because it will all unfold in front of your very eyes, and it's all getting underway now. This is the first on the ice from Italy, Gilberto Viadana. Been on the Italian team now for 8 years, and he was 24th after the short program. His music is from a tribute to Astor Piazzolla, Gilberto Viadana.
Opening up with the triple Lutz. Excellent jump. And the axle, outside edge. Not going to work. The double flip, double toe. Triple toe, half loop, triple toe. That's the sequence done. Paying a lot of attention to the judges. Second triple Lutz, the hand down the ice, not good. Triple Sauco. A minute to go, you'll need to get some spins in. Jump change sit, but it's under revved, only 5 revs. Second one for good measure.
So Gilberto opens the batting here at White Ring. Gilberto Viadana, who happens to also enjoy snowboarding.
I think this is probably why I was in 24th position running in the short program, and probably my greatest criticism of this program was the lack of the spins. But here we see the triple Lutz. The opening triple Lutz was the best jump of the program. Good running edge. That was a terrific opening. And here we come into what should have been the... there we go, triple toe. Good feet down in the half loop. Step back, toe in, and up to the triple toe again. And that's a jump sequence that's required in the free program for the men. They can do any jump, but they have to do either a jump combination or a jump sequence.
Gilberto trains in Italy during the winter, then heads to Lake Arrowhead in California during the summer. And has done well to make it into the top 24.
And I think the next time he skates, he's probably going to have to pay a little bit more attention to his spins, because you do have to stay in your spins for more than the 3 or 4 revs that he was making. He's a good spinner, no reason why he couldn't sit there and continue on with the spin.
Give me a good chat to someone right down the barrel.
He's Italian, he's allowed to chat, he's using his hands.
It's going to be interesting to see how the judges start tonight, isn't it, too? They're our good friends.
Pouring over that, I'd say that'd be around about mid-fours, and it'll work up through the night until we get to Elvis Stoico, Todd Eldridge.
Just as we build up, yes, those big guns coming up a little bit later on, and you're right, low to mid-fours, as far as technical is concerned, for Gilberto.
There was no triple axel landed and no actual triple-triple combination, so I think that reflects that mark.
Yeah, and I think he accepts that. So from Gilberto, we go to a young man who's just delighted to be here. Margus Hernits from Estonia. Been on the national team now for 6 years, and his free skating program is to the music from Waterworld.
Jump combination to begin. Triple flip, he's having a good night so far. the men are required to move through field moves or spiral type movements across the whole ice rink, and that's what Marcus is doing at the moment. Building up some speed, triple salco, double toe. Spin, camel, sit position, right down low, change sit.
Very sound and a very clean program from Margus Hurnitz, who is just happy to qualify for this final after the dramas of 94 when he lost most of the screws out of one of his skates during the short program. He was allowed to re-skate after the skate had been repaired, but he failed to qualify for the men's final. But the good news is here in Nagano, he has made it, and that is a grand performance.
This is the opening triple lutz. Very high. And double toe. I think he might have wanted to do the triple. He has got to go away so happy from this. The three turn, back inside edge, pick, and there's the flip. Three rotations. He's going to skate away and go, I've done a perfect performance. Maybe the only thing that he'd pick at is that he did a double toe near the end of the program instead of a triple, but all of the spins rotated. There is nothing to deduct, and the judges can take a few deductions in the free program.
19th after the short program. I'm looking forward to seeing these quads. Are the quad squad going to be out and about tonight, and will we see them here on 7?
The quad squad will be here, and you're going to see them very, very soon, Sandy. They'll be here.
It's incredible, isn't it? They will be amazing to watch. These marks considerably higher than Gilberto Viadana's. But you would expect that too after a very clean performance.
Yes, he may actually even pull up a place or two by virtue of other people going for more and making mistakes. And he's probably got a lot to do in the artistic side, as you can see here from these marks. He needs to develop that side of his skating a little bit more posture.
Next on the ice is a man who's been 10 times Romanian champion. He's a 26-year-old. His name is Cornel Gorga. And he's free skating to the music, the soundtrack from Lassiter. After the short program, Cornel Gorga.
happening up with the axle. Oh, it's only a double. Handy little rest right at the beginning of the program. Very quick triple, it's double toe. Back outside edge, leaned outside the edge on that one. Spin. Good position, but very short. Double oots, that's a number of doubles for Cornell now. He'll be wanting to get in one more triple jump. There it is, triple salco. Two more triple jumps. Spin flying camel to a back sit.
Romania's Cornel Gorga. He's done it pretty tough over a number of years now. Lost his coach, unfortunately, due to a heart attack. That was only, what, hours, I think, before he was due to perform in the World Championships back in 1997.
Yes, only a year ago.
Yeah.
I would have liked to have seen Cornell use that music a little bit more choreographically. This is the Lutz. Another scatter opening up with a good triple Lutz into the double toe. The men really in this competition are going to have to later on do the triple-triple combinations, and here is the toe loop, which is only a double. and that really needs to be a triple jump. None of these men, if they want to climb any of the places, can afford to do anything but triple jumps.
And if you're sitting at home and you think the double looks difficult, wait till you see the quads.
Mm, twice as hard.
That coach I was talking about, of course, was Carlo Fassi, whose wife, Krista, is still working with Cornell.
A very famous coaching team, coached Robin Cousins, who's been entertaining us all week long.
Certainly has. And I've never known anyone to be more enthusiastic about ice dancing, I've got to say, than Robin. He loved it, didn't he?
Take it away, it was. This will sit in between, I would say, the first and the second skater that we've seen. And some of his jumps are solid, and he's not going to incur the deductions on the spins like Viadani from Italy did in the first skater.
Remember, tonight we're seeing 24 skaters, the 24 best in the world who qualified. And at the end of the night, we'll know who has won gold, silver and bronze. This is a 21-year-old from Uzbekistan, Roman Skorniakov. Student on the national team for 3 years. He was 20th after the short program. His short program was to Can-Can. His free program is to Flame of Paris. Roman Skorniakov.
Up, triple axel hopefully. Beautifully done. Triple toe. It's a big deal for the fourth skater out. Running down all the triple jumps now, it's Lutz. Second triple axel. It is, but it doesn't work. Way outside the circle. Triple loop, over rotated. Back for a man. What they call moves in the field with the spread eagles and spirals and held edges. Footwork, I want to get a bit more of a move on now and a little bit more speed. just made it. Double Salco, triple toe, 30 seconds to go, get those jumps in. A good camel spin. You can see he's not moving at all.
Well, not a lot. But a good performance by Roman Skuniakov. Trains in Tashkent in Uzbekistan.
Such a fantastic opening, triple axel, triple toe, and all of his marks will hit in a near 5.0 due to that one opening jump. But here we go, the opening. Triple axel. Good running edge into this triple toe and coming off onto the back outside edge and held landing. And here's the Lutz. Good tight position. Right hand was going towards the ice on the landing, but didn't happen, and he'll hit pay dirt for that. It's difficult when skaters have a mixed program like he's just done, because technically it was right up there and artistically it was struggling through the program a little bit, and we'll see what happens in the marks, how it reflects that.
20th after the short program, so there won't be any major moves from Roman, one wouldn't think.
Well, again, it's hard to say with the opening. I think we'll see that through the night a lot, where the skaters will open up with the big guns. If they're able to do the quad, they're going to do it first or second jump. That's not something that you save to later in the program. So he's opened up with his biggest trick and basically run down the scale of the jumps, with the triple axel, triple toe being his hardest, then the triple lutz and so on. He's done a good job.
As we count down to the gold medal on this Valentine's Day, who will it be? 4-6, 4-8, 4-7, 4-7. Technical scores coming through now and ranging from 4-5 to 5.1. Whilst for presentation, 4-7, 5-0, 4-6, 4-7, similar variance, similar range.
I think the 4-5, 4-5 from the French judge is a little harsh. I don't think I would have had him anywhere other than first or second at this point of the skaters that have come on. However, they're all entitled to their opinion.
And now the young man who was 22nd after the short program, who's a 21-year-old from Switzerland, Patrick Meyer, and he's going to be skating his free program to Tarantella by John Lurie.
Double three out of it, no deduction. to Lutz. That's the best jump he's done. Selko for the judges, and a good running edge. Try this axle again. He had the same technical error. Keeping the character throughout the whole program. Behind too. Try it again. There you go. Good sit spin. Back camel to a pull up. Repeat two triple jumps, and he's repeating the axle and the Lutz, and that's called a single. Final spin, flying camel. Jump over forward sit.
Patrick Meyer of Switzerland, the 21-year-old who's, interestingly enough, been on the national team now for 7 years, so made it when he was just 14. Works out some 20 hours a week and is highly talented, speaks three languages. Loves a number of sports, including diving and volleyball. And his mother designed his costume.
Here we see the opening triple axel, and you'll just see his body weight go outside the jump. And he really couldn't get over the top of his feet at all through the air. I'm hoping this is the first Lutz, the one that rotated. And this, again, like the skater before him, was the best jump of the program.
I was going to say Patrick finished 22nd after the short program, and it certainly won't change too much.
He kept in character through that whole piece of music, but I don't think that he involved his body as much as he did with his hands and his head in this performance. But the men, more than anything, know that they've got to get all the triple jumps done. That's that if they want to move up in this field and really make a mark, that they're going to have to get something like 8 triple jumps done, and indeed the quads, which we will see very soon. But he's happy with his performance.
I'll read a little bit later on an extraordinary fax we received from a young lady who's an Elvis fan. I'll just read some of it. That's an Elvis Stoico fan, by the way. But it was very touching. His mark's coming through now. That's probably going to place him around fourth or fifth at the moment.
Interesting to see what this panel does with the artistic, being mostly what I call a European panel. Yes, they've gone up. So there's a lot of deductions, not completing jump sequences and a jump combination.
Places Patrick in fourth place at the moment. And completing this first group is Ki Hyun Lee of Korea, who was 23rd after the short program. Just 17 years of age, but highly talented on the ice. And skating to a medley that includes I Love Paris, Leon and Subanay, and Sway.
A lot of music in 4 minutes. Very unorthodox technique this young man has, so it's going to be difficult to get a lot of triple jumps done. Good flip. Creating that air position. Very brooding sort of look about his skating. Coming up for the Lutz, left back outside edge. Not surprising. Same problem for the triple toe. Flying camel? Will it go 8 revs? That's how far it's got to go. 7. Thank you. break very much, and he'll need to work on that for his next piece. Triple, double lutz, double toe, very slow. And in the old days, it was called a broken leg spin.
Kyuhyun Lee, I'm still thinking about that broken leg spin.
I can't help thinking at this point that Anthony Liu must be feeling very, very sorry that he only did a double toe off the the triple lutz, because Anthony's a very good skater.
Well, Kyuhyun Lee is only 17 years of age, and Korean have got some very good skaters, including their short speed skaters who are outstanding.
Here's the triple lutz again. Like the rest of the competitors in this group, at best jump of the group. And here it is. Here's the broken leg spin. With the leg turned in and out to the side instead of the normal position, turned out to the front.
Learning so much from you, from broken leg spins to twizzles. The old twizzle. That's an interesting one. But the Kyuhyun Lee completes our first group as we count down to gold here at White Ring tonight, and here come his scores. Firstly, for his technical merit, just fours. Well, a 3.8 actually from the French judge, going to a 4.3. And presentation also varying around the 4 to 4.4. So he's currently in sixth place. We shall take a break from White Ring, but I hope you can stay with us. We're counting down to the gold medal here tonight.
Yes! She's looking for a big run to the line. Can she get it?
Oh, no! She can't believe it!
But a number of visitors here tonight. In fact, I saw one Japanese person dressed up as Santa Claus, so they've obviously had a problem with the calendar.
Yes, well, it's still the right sort of weather for Santa in this part of the world, I imagine. Zagorodnyuk's actually trying to warm up a quad toe, so he might say an attempt at a quad out of this group. And seen him try it a number of times in practice. So.
In what, just to give people at home an idea, what time span are we talking for a quad?
Quad toe loop is an outside three, step back, pick with the toe, in the air for maybe 0.6 to 0.8 of a second.
Turn four times.
Turn four times, come down on 1 foot, right back outside edge.
So you're in the air to turn four times for 0.7 of a second.
About that.
I might have a crack at that later.
Well, it's not a very long time, really, is it?
It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. So the warm-up is complete for this second group. There'll be a huge roar for Takeshi Honda, the 16-year-old who'll open up proceedings in front of his home crowd, coached by Galina Zmivskaya for the past year, who coached such champions as Viktor Petrenko, the 92 gold medalist, and 94 gold medalist Oksana Bayul. Listen to that roar for Takeshi Honda of Japan. And the music he's chosen, Belinda, is from El Cid.
He'll have a lot to prove tonight, because he didn't have a very good skate in the short program, and it's, he'll be wanting to gain. Axel, and that was perfect. Trying triple flip. Thank you. loop.
Gee, the standard's been lifted.
Flying Camel short on the revs, but a good position. Steps into Triple Lutz. Looking at his coach, very happy now. Second triple axel coming up. A little too far forward. Takeshi can do the quad. He's decided not to do it tonight. That's called butterfly into a star. Triple sail, double toe combination.
Just 16 years of age in front of his home crowd. What a moment for Takeshi Honda. He started out as a short track speed skater. And will take 20 minutes to get the flowers off this rink now.
He's very emotional at the moment. I think that he knows that he's redeemed himself in his own mind and his own eyes after the his perceived failure in the short program. Actually, it was a very good program outside the...
Do you like bears? There's probably 10 of them on the ice.
Love bears.
It's unbelievable. Crowd very, very generous.
Outside the second triple axel, it was a marvellous performance, but what I liked is the, here's the triple axel now. Perfect feet position and so straight over the blade on the landing. Complete stretch on the finish. And here's the second one, and you'll see that the body language is just a little bit more crouched and he just gets too far forward on the finish of the jump. And down he goes. And that was probably fatigue.
It's one of the bears. He's copying them from everywhere. Very, very popular here in Nagano. And still only a student.
What I like so much, here he is with his coach, Galina. And There we have the Japanese boy learning from the Russian coach in America. Very international sport.
Well, he's got some big shoes to fill, hasn't he? Viktor Petrenko and Oksana Bayul, both gold medalists, both Olympic gold medalists.
I liked his musicality. I liked how he was spot on with the music the whole way through his stretch extension. I think that these marks really reflect the quality of what he did. Only one mistake, and everything that he did was very good quality. Hope the Russian judge doesn't get stuck later on. I don't think the Japanese will, because I think the Japanese will judge will keep him up there. Clear leader so far, Sandy.
Yes, good performance by Takeshi. Of course, his countryman, Yamato Tamura, is still to come, but in the meantime, the man who finished 17th after the short program from Canada, Jeff Langdon, free skating to the St. Louis Blues, Harlem Nocture, and Chuchucha Boogie. Get your skates on. Here we go, Jeff Langdon of Canada.
To left, opening up with a single axel. That won't be good for Jeffrey. Easy triple flip, triple toe, slightly hooked around on the landing. Fast footwork into good triple sout, triple loop combination. Excellent jump. Speed through this program is very good. A straight spread eagle all the way down the rink. Very clever. Clever Canadians are known for their good fast footwork. Triple Lutz. He's repeated the flip. Butterfly back sit. Good sitting position.
An excellent routine from Jeff Langdon from Canada. Is he going to be one of the young guns that may take over from Elvis Stoiko in the years to come? Well, he's already been on the national team since 1993, coming from Smith Falls in Ontario. And it'd be Smith Falls' favourite son at the moment.
Well, that was a wonderful performance from Jeffrey Langdon. Again, he had a point to prove. He's done better than he has in the short program. Coached by Elvis's coach, Doug Lee, and his choreography by Doug's wife, Michelle. And here is the triple sow triple loop combination, which Tara Lipinski from the United States does. But that's a very tough combination. Only other man I've seen do that is Kurt Browning, also from Canada. And here is the second attempt of the triple axel, which was successful. Very quick free leg right to the back on that landing. There he is with his choreographer and coach, Michelle Lee.
You mentioned Kurt Browning, of course. He was the first to give us the quad. That was in the 88 World Championships. I'm dying to see them here tonight. I'm dying to see the first one. Will it be Zagar, do you think?
I think he might attempt it. I think that he knows he's got nothing to lose, so he'll give it a go. Oh, no, Doug's not looking after Elvis. He's there with Jeffrey too, so... And he'd be happy to be there. He's had a great skate. He's had a lot to prove, Jeffrey, because he's actually third in the Canadian Nationals behind another young gun. And they've elected to send Jeffrey because of his international experience, and I think that he's just proved a point.
How exhausting is a routine like that, Belinda?
About 80 minutes worth of football. You really need to have a really big aerobic capacity to get through this. The last minute is very, very tough. The lactic's kicking in and the chest is burning.
For technical merit, here come the scores, ranging from 5-1 to 5-5. By the Great Britain and Canadian judges. That will probably place him though above Takeshi Honda.
And so it should too. It was a very strong performance, and it was a triple-triple combination in that program, and that's what will give him so many marks, that and the triple axel.
Well, Japan's fans can really let their hair down again now, because here's another of their own. He's just 18 years of age, Yamato Tamura, who happens to like musical chairs. It's a nightmare, isn't it?
Someone has to live it.
And he's skating his free program to the Umbrellas of Cherbourg.
Up with a triple Lutz. Gorgeous. Triple toe. Extra gorgeous. Covered a lot of distance in that triple Lutz. It was a big jump. Axel second. Only a double. Oh. Building up speed for another big triple jump. The flip. It's only a double. Spins are a problem for Yamato. These aren't really great positions. Very crouched over and bent. Second Lutz, and it's a single. Step sequence. Men have to perform two in the free program. And back together with a triple salchow, I was nearly going to say, but not working. I think too tired. Ina Bauer into double axel and triple toe. Stars, butterfly, back set.
Well, he finished 15th after the short program, but the jumps certainly proving to be a problem for him, Belinda, tonight.
Takeshi had a bad run in the short and a fantastic free program and really brought it home. And I think Yamato at this point would like to have had a better free program. The flips and the Lutzes were all running off the same edge. The flip jump comes off an inside edge, a Lutz comes off an outside edge, and he was flipping between the two on both of the entries for those jumps. And every time that happened, he would come up with a single, which is really what you don't have happen. Here we have it here. There's the Lutz that he opened up with. The triple Lutz into the triple toe, which was the best feature of the program, and it was an excellent jump. And here we're having a go at the triple loop. And the air position nowhere near as tight as the Lutz. And there's the foot's running flat and into the triple salchow. And just didn't seem to get enough height up off the front of the skate on the takeoff for that one.
Still, you'd have to say the sport's in pretty good hands with Yamato and Takeshi, still only 16 and 18 years of age respectively.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, Takeshi tonight, I think, was superb and mature, and I think that probably this boy needs to mature a lot. That happens with the men's skaters. They get to this age and everything sort of changes. They grow a lot and then they get strong, and that's what Yamato will be doing probably in the next season.
Spends his time between Japan and Marlborough in the United States as far as training is concerned. He's here in the winter, over in the States during the summer. All part of the learning process for Yamato Tamura as we count down towards the gold. We're approaching the halfway mark and the tension and the excitement is starting to build here in White Ring.
Well, yes, it's nearly halfway through the event and only a few left in this group, and the third group on a fantastic
after sport. This, we are left with the top 12, and the gold, silver and bronze will come from those top 12.
Like I said earlier, that this group will probably be sitting around the 4.950, and this is probably a really good example of it. Very good opening with the triple Lutz, triple toe, and then the program probably fading a little bit in the middle and towards the end. that music had very much of a sameness for me, and it didn't show very much light and shade.
Onto the ice now, a very interesting young skater from Israel. He immigrated to Israel back in 1990. His name is Michael Shmerkin. And free skating to Romania and Jewish folk music, including David. Finished 14th after the short program. Teaches the art of figure skating. And now he's going to show us what he teaches. Michael Shmerkin.
Opening with the Lutz. Not fully rotated. Comes the axle, forward takeoff, only double, but beautifully done. Triple loop he just hung on to. This will get the crowd going. And Michael needs to get through some more triple jumps at this point. One coming up. Nope, axel is double. Triple toe. I think his music choice is really good, and I do like some of the choreography that he's using with it. He'll just need to up his technical input to be able to gain some more marks. It's a triple salco laterally. Finally had a go at the triple axel. A better triple salco than the one before, but not in combination. Here comes a second jump, double toe. Flying Camel, jump over backseat.
Michael Schmerken from Israel, who finished 14th after the short program, but in all honesty will struggle to hold that position.
There's not enough technical merit, Mark, here available with only a couple of triple jumps. Only a couple of triple jumps done, and very bad triple salco done late in the program. I called it a lateral triple salco, which isn't a real jump. But it was just done much too bent over. Here's the triple Lutz that didn't rotate to backwards. There was a quarter of a turn missing on that, and he couldn't make it work. And here's a triple Salco. Again, very sideways, but he did. That was about the best jump in the program, and that's going to be his problem in the technical merit mark. I like his spins. I like his style. I actually like the music choice. But the mark's going to be well down in the fours is my prediction.
Michael's been competing internationally since 1985, and his best result as a junior was fourth in the junior worlds back in 1986.
Trains in Moscow and Finland a lot of the time with Marina Kudratsieva.
I won't ask you to spell it. And he lives in Israel.
Judges will take a while with Michael's marks because the quality of the construction of the program is very good, but the technical element wasn't there. So what do they do? Do they give him 4.5 and 5.0? And again, I think there's probably some deductions in the spins that didn't complete the rotations, the revolutions.
We're approaching the halfway mark of the program. At the end of the night, we're going to be seeing the big guns like Elvis, Eldridge, Kulik and Yagodin. At this stage, would they have arrived? Would they be here?
I think Elvis is in the building.
Ooh. It's only the eighth time that's been used this week. Well, there's so much, all of Canada is going to be behind Elvis and see if he can get rid of that monkey off the back as far as world champions are concerned, coming to an Olympic Games. There you can see the scores for Michael. 4-7, 4-6, and 4-6. Now for presentations. Varying from 4-8 to 5-2. 5-1, 5-0, 5-0. So a couple left in this second group. And is one of these going to show us the quad? Well, stay with us and we'll see. First up. This is the young man from Azerbaijan. In fact, not so young now in this sport, 26 years of age. Igor Pashkovich, who was born in Moscow and is now skating his free program to Rachmaninoff's Piano Concerto No. 1.
Beautiful, stylish skater who has been second in Europeans. If he's in form, this will be a good performance. Try that triple axel again, and again a double. Disaster now for Igor. Good triple Lutz. Into triple toe. That's more like the man we know. Thank you. move to a forward inside edge. Program, but he'll need some speed. Triple Salco. Triple flip, too slow. Triple loop. Spin the camel, back camel, jump over, and it's a forward sit spin.
Igor Pashkovic from Azerbaijan. No rinks in Azerbaijan, but he trains in Moscow and Finland. He's had some good results in the past, as you mentioned, second in the European Championships back in 1996. But how did you assess that program after finishing 13th in the short?
I think he's such an elegant skater, but I think that the music actually overpowered his skating. I didn't think it was strong enough and fast enough. Two very good triple Lutzes. Did the loop, the sail, the toe. There's the triple Lutz. And it was a long time till he made it to the triple toe for the sequence. And here's the triple loop. Little bit tilting forwards, you can see there. And struggle on the landing. No flow on the blade at the finish of the jump. And the judges are watching for that. I just didn't think the speed was powerful enough.
He's been on the national team for 2 years. But has had the same coach since 1979. I call him Marina. What's her surname?
Kudratsieva.
Well done.
I think a lot of people expected more of Igor over the last 2 years than he's been able to produce. He was the 1990 junior world champion, and many thought that he would be the skater to watch really come these Olympics 2 or 3 years ago, and he just hasn't seemed to have been able to go on with it. He's got a good technique in the air when he gets enough speed, when he doesn't, using the body too much to get himself around.
As he waits, Vyacheslav Zagorodnyuk warms up from Ukraine, and could Zaga give us our first quad for the night?
I saw him trying them in practice. I didn't actually see him land any of them. It looked to be a quarter of a turn out, and I don't know, he's in a position where he can risk it because he's so far down, but also he doesn't want to be going down on the ice and losing marks in his artistic side either. So it's a hard ask. Those with the courage will try it.
Well, he'll be so keen to do something, won't he, after a 16th in the short. It was
was unbelievable, really.
It's what you call the nightmare skate, and it's his worst result at World Championships, as I can recall.
Well, now, why would the judges be taking so much time over this one?
I think because of his, you know, reputation.
Yeah, well, here it comes now. Bearing from 4-7 to 5-2 for technical merit.
There were no triple-triple combinations in this performance, and I think that you'd have to place it around about where Takeshi Honda was for the same type of performance. The artistic marks are definitely keeping him up there in contention.
He's currently in second spot behind Jeff Langdon, but we're only just halfway, and it's going to be interesting to see what this man can do. He was seventh in the European Championships earlier this year. A very, very exciting skater. But after having that nightmare in the short program, let's see what he can produce. Vyacheslav Zagorodnyuk, free skating to the music of Prokofiev, Alexander Nevsky.
Too fast into a double toe. Going to be the quad. He elected to do the triple. Trademark spin for Zaggy. Consistent now. That's harder than it looks. Dark piece of music here in the centre of the program. Triple loop turned into a double. Speed's good though. Triple Salco. Good one. Into triple toe.
Well, he wanted to atone for his short program, and I think he's gone part of the way of doing that.
That was what I'd call a very mixed performance, opening up with the triple axel was just much too fast, and it travelled across the ice, incredible speed watching it here. And the second one, he had much more under control. And so he had a good triple axel, a few good lutzes, one good lutz, a very up and down performance. Here's the first axel, I think. Huge, he just couldn't control the finish of it and stepped right up into the double toe. That might fool some of the people some of the time. And here's the second one. Just took his time a little bit more on the takeoff. Got right up over that right side, perfect air position, and straight down over that back outside edge for the landing. Textbook triple axel, the second one was.
So that brings us to the halfway mark as we head towards the golden moments here in White Ring. Later to come tonight, the big four, Elvis Stoiko from Canada, Todd Eldridge from America, Ilya Kulik, who is leading from Russia, and his countryman Alexei Yagodin. Surely we're going to see the quads from some of those.
No quads yet. I think I can almost guarantee one, though, from the Chinese boy, Zheng Jingao.
Well, I hope you're right.
I'll go out on a limb.
Okay. He is in the next group, which we'll be seeing shortly. There will be a resurfacing of the ice. It'll take place shortly. But there's more joy there than there was after the short program, isn't there?
Yes, again.
Stone faced, I think, is the word, the phrase I would have used the other night.
Yeah, mixed performance, and I think he knows it. I think it was smart not to try the quad toe. If he's, you've got to be feeling perfect. I believe that you can't really coach a quad toe. Just some skaters have a real feeling for it, and on days when you're on and you're able to spin in the air, you can. Judges still taking their time. I think they're trying to decide whether they want to keep Jeffrey Langdon in his place where he's at the moment leading the event, or give Zaggy a run. But again, there's no triple-triple combination from Zagorodniok.
Have a look at the scores now as they come through. Firstly, for technical merit, ranging from 5.0 to 5.6. And now for presentation, as he looks to go ahead of Jeff Langdon and Paskovic. And he'll do that. So here's our leader at the moment, after 12. We've got the top 12 still to come here from White Ring. More shortly, stay with us.
Channel 7 and Holden are giving you the chance to win this all-new, more powerful, soon-to-be-released 1998 Holden Jackaroo V6. All you have to do is keep watching 7's telecast of the Nagano Olympic Winter Games and pick up your copy of Who Weekly and answer the three questions relating to the Winter Olympics, send in your entry coupon and you could win.
As the excitement and tension builds here, it's going to be a golden night. We're now in the second half of the program. That's where our gold medals are going to come from. But there has been some drama, Belinda. Alexei Yagodin is one of the top four contenders. You've been speaking with his coach during the break, and all is not well with Alexei.
I ran into Misha and patted him on the back and said, good luck for tonight. And he just turned around as quick as anything and said, he's sick.
What's that mean? He's got the dreaded flu that everyone seems to be getting here?
Well, that's what I said. Sick with what? And he said he's sick. He's got the flu. He's, you know, not well. So, but he's strong. And I still think that for 4.5 minutes of one life that you can carry it through. And if he's able to skate at all, then he'll do the best he can. He still looked okay in practice here this morning and yesterday.
Mind you, there was a rumour also before the short program that Elvis was not well.
and he seemed to skate quite okay.
And Misha's quite the political player too, so we'll have to wait and see.
What about this next group? What can we expect? For example, someone like Michael Weiss. Now, I'd like just to read a quote to you from Michael, and this was said in the last 2 days. This will be good news. I'm going to try and do the quad Lutz and 8 other triples, so maybe he could be the first for the night to give us the quad.
Well, he's a physically very strong skater and he's been working on his physical condition for quite a number of years, and coming from his background with, you know, parents in gymnastics and swimming and everything else, he's probably one of the very few Americans that seriously took on major weight training, which American skaters haven't ever done before. And in the US National Championships, he did do the quad Lutz, but he just put down the free foot and so that they counted that as a 2 foot landing, but he did get almost all the way around it and stayed on his feet, and there's no question in my mind that he'll try it.
When does a skater decide that if he is going to do it or not? I mean, is it decided well before the program, or is it something on the spur of the moment while he's actually skating? He suddenly thinks, oh, Jiminy, I can't do this.
Well, less time that it takes to say Jiminy is when they don't. That's when it doesn't happen.
I was going to say something else, but no. But, I mean, it can be a spur of the moment thing.
If you've decided not to do the quad at all, that's decided when you're off the ice. When you're actually skating the program and between you and the coach you've made the decision to try the quad and it doesn't happen, then that's something that happens in like 0.1 of a second in the air, and it's almost not a conscious thought. It's just that your body knows that it's not spinning properly on top of the skate and you pull out.
Well, what about the young man from China, Zhenjin Gao? What can we expect from him?
In the warm-up, he did just gorgeous triple axel, triple toe combinations, and I think that he'll try two quads. I think that he may even try the quad triple combination and then try and repeat the quad again later on, which he was indeed the first skater to ever do two quads in one program.
Thinking of the women as well, how strong are the Chinese?
Well, his compatriot Liu Chen was actually the 1995 world champion, had a terrible time in 1997 world championships and didn't even qualify, didn't make the top 24. She was injured. The Chinese officials basically made her skate so that they could get an Olympic spot. She failed. They had to send her off to the qualifying event in Vienna, which she came second at. She is a beautiful, elegant skater. Grown a lot between when she was 15 and 17, and probably maybe not technically as strong as she used to be, but I think we've got something to see.
Okay then, well, let's continue our program now here at White Ring. This huge roar for the American Michael Weiss from the United States, and after being 11th in the short program, are we going to see our first quad? He'll be skating to the Egmont Overture, Piano Sonata number 13.
Going to try the quad. This will be it.
Come on.
Tried the quad, not all the way around. Triple toe, 2 foot of that toe, I think. Triple flip, triple toe. It's a very good combination. outside edge camel spin. Triple axel, double. Wonderful choreography. Triple loop coming up. Nicely done. In the last 20 seconds of the program, showing his strength. Jump change set to finish.
Well, no quad, but a stunning performance from Michael Weiss. If ever someone was bred to be an athlete, it is Michael. His father was on the 64 US Olympic team as a gymnast. His sisters have been involved in figure skating and diving. His mother's been involved in gymnastics as well. And as we start the second half of the night, it's a pretty exciting performance, Belinda.
Here's the attempt at the quad. Lutz, one, two, three. Just couldn't get quite around the fourth, but he gave it a go. I really enjoyed this program. Here's the triple axel, triple toe. We'll have a look at the finish of the triple toe. One, two, three and a half revolutions for the triple axel. Reach back, up into the triple toe. One, two, yep. Free toe went down into the ice. He didn't let any of this music go by. There he is with his wife. And she knows artistically he's done a great job. I thought that the package of this program was like 5.6.
Yes, they only married last year. Lisa Thornton is choreographer in September of last year. There she is. And he was a marvellous junior, second in 93 at the World Championships in Seoul. In 94, he won the World Juniors in Colorado Springs.
And barely out of breath sitting there. Very, very strong athlete. And I think that we'll see more of Michael Weiss in the next few years. I think that he'll manage that quad, Lutz. I think he should go after the quad toe. It doesn't seem to be a problem for him to be able to get the speed and the height. He's just not quite getting enough quick rotation.
Very talented sportsman, because he was also a former regional diving champion. And he said he was going to go for the quad. He did, and he didn't quite make it. But let's see how he scores here at White Ring tonight. Firstly, for technical merit, that's very good. This should take him to the top of the table for those that we've seen tonight. And now for presentation. Yes, straight to the top.
Thanks, guys. start.
And now onto the ice from the Ukraine, a 24-year-old who in his own right is a very talented musician. Dmitry Dmitrienko. The music he's skating to is ballet music from Shostakovich, from The Young Lady and the Hooligan. Here he is, Dmitry Dmitrienko.
Triple axle, turning the double toe. Won't get paid for the axle though. Very forward. Speed isn't anything like the previous skater, Michael Weiss. Double flip. Question that he feels his music. Unusual spins. Side axle, don't see that very often. Triple salco, half loop, double salco. Speed. He can rotate well, not enough speed. Pushing through the program a little right towards the end. This one may work. And it does. Mm-hmm.
Big finish for Dmitry Dmitrienko from the Ukraine, the 24-year-old who finished eighth after the short program.
I think he was probably playing the hooligan in this one, Sandy.
Well, he had the choice.
Certainly did. I thought that this program was a little bit frantic in the action, particularly in the upper body, and it wasn't really covering the ice with the feet down the bottom. Here comes the triple axle, and it's two-footed, and he can't get his balance, so he hops around into the double toe, which is zero flow coming off that. And here's the triple salchow, not getting over that landing foot well enough. Hop off into the double salchow. I think he would have liked to have made that a triple. Balance was not there.
But a dream come true for Dmitry, who was unable to compete in the 94 Winter Games because the Ukraine's only spot was then taken by the 92 gold medalist in Viktor Petrenko. So he gets his chance here at Nagano. As we continue to count our way down to the really big names in the sport and those that are right in contention for the gold, silver and bronze. Elva Stoyko, Todd Eldridge, Ilya Kulik, and the word is out from the Yagodin camp that he's not 100%. So maybe that'll open the door for someone else. Perhaps a Stephen Cousins of Great Britain. Who knows? And then, of course, there's the exciting Philippe Candeloro. All those stars are in their final group. That is the next group you'll be seeing here on Seven. So I hope you can stay with us and enjoy it. Just as Minnie is. Is that Minnie? You're probably more up on mice than me.
Yes, that's. I think that's Minnie Mouse. She's got very big eyes, this Minnie Mouse.
So would you if you'd just been thrown onto the ice from about 50 metres, which she had. Ah, dear. Now, the scores are about to come up for Dmitry. Let's see how he's fared. Firstly, for technical merit. And a fair range there from 4-6 to 5.1. 4-6 coming from the Great Britain judge and 5-1 from the Japan judge.
I think Zagorodnyuk is going to be able to look at a major move upwards through this. He might have been moving up into the top 10 somewhere. And Dmitry Dmitrienko will not be able to hold his position, I don't think, overall.
No, in fact, at the moment, that will leave him behind Zagorodnyuk. But as we go back to the ice, a 19-year-old from Bulgaria. His name is Ivan Dinev. A young man who likes computers, so we'd all get on extremely well with him. And his free skating program is from the soundtrack Desperado. Ivan Dinev. Bulgaria.
Triple Lutz, beautiful running edge in and out of the jump. Triple flip off steps. second triple axel. Have to do it in sequence, into triple toe. First glitch in the program, all the jumps have been absolutely fabulous. Tiring a little now because that was only a double loop. And the flying camel into the back sit. Our flamenco feel steps. Skaters are going to tire. It's going to be in the second or third minute, and I think that that's what's happened to Ivan. He's going to have to need a big finish. Legs are gone, I'd say.
Well, maybe he just lasted. But he looks pretty exhausted now, but happy with his performance. Ivan Dinev, who skated to Sunset Boulevard in his short program and finished seventh. That time it was to Desperado. But plenty left, though, for the 19-year-old who would have a great future. This is just his first Olympic Games, and he's been on the international team now since he was 13. So he's an old hand and still a teenager.
It was a very big opening. Huge, very, very high triple axel. And he nailed it. And here was the second triple axel that he has to combine with another jump to be able to get a score for the triple axel itself. So he put it with the triple toe, reached back up into the air for the triple toe. Very big opening of the program, and around about the 2:15 mark, he just started to fade away.
I've got one question for you. I know that a number of the moves are named after skaters and former skaters. Who was the flying camel named after?
I don't know, maybe
Pat
it was...
Welsh?
Could have been. Could have been. Axel is named after a man called Axel Paulson. The Selko, Jurik Selko.
No one named Camel?
Not as far as I know, but maybe that's just because I'm not old enough.
Couple more left in this group, then we will be down to the final group that comprises Ilya Kulik, Todd Eldridge, Alexei Yagodin, Stephen Cousins, Philippe Candeloro and Elvis Stoiko, the biggest names in men's figure skating. And it's one of those who tonight will be the gold medalist. One will be the silver and one will take the bronze. Good build-up, isn't it? It's great excitement in this magnificent stadium at the moment. Tension building. Can't wait to see those really big stars.
Well, I'm on the edge of my seat. It is very, very important whoever wins that gold medal. I can't even begin to talk about the dollar terms as far as anything else, but just the ability to be able to come out here in front of everybody and be able to take away a gold medal. It's fantastic.
Ivan gives Kermit a good old workout as we check the scores. Well, it's going to put him behind Michael Weiss of America, who's leading at the moment, and also Tillerson.
I would have expected those artistic marks to drop quite drastically. He really lost the thread of that program in the last couple of minutes.
What about Sarbol? A quad from him, do you think?
We'll have to wait and see.
Well, we won't have to wait long because he's coming onto the ice now. 20-year-old from Hungary, Szabolcs Vidrai. Free skating, this will be a nice quiet show. All hell broke loose, boys in the hood, and the Rocky Horror Picture Show. It's just a jump to the left. Here he is, Szabolcs Vidrai. On your bike.
I think all these men who can do quads are really feeling the pressure. They know that everybody is out there going to try them, and one by one they're opting to stay on their feet. And Sandy, he's dressed for all hell broke loose too.
Certainly is, but he's really got the crowd going. Full house here tonight at White Ring. Oh!
Triple axel, triple toe, and it's a good one. Triple toe, that was going to be a quad, it was a triple now. Comes a triple lutz, and it's a beautiful jump. The double toe on the end, and the crowd is right with him. Stars butterfly. Section of the program, which is always the slow piece. Combination spin, camel, sit. Back camel, back sit. Repeat of the Lutz. Really his first mistake, that single axel.
Coming home with a Rocky Horror Show.
He jumps the left now, he'll be in with the judges. Triple flip. No flowing edge at the end of that, that doesn't matter at this stage. Triple Salco.
The vehicle comes to a halt, and so too does Zabol Vidrai of Hungary. An excellent performance, and he really got them going, Belinda.
I think that that was a really unusual free program, and I think that the crowd really liked it. Whether the judges do or not in down there altogether is still yet to be seen. I enjoyed it. I think that it was something different, and it was a fantastic opening. Barely any mistakes here. Here we see the opening triple axel. 1, 2, 3 and a half revolutions. Reach back, pick the toe, and up for three revs for the triple toe. Two-footed that. And the triple lutz, crank that foot over on the outside edge into a double toe. All in all, quite a good performance. The choreography, the costume, it all stayed right in character right from start to finish.
Only 20 years of age, but he's had the same coach now for a decade, been on the national team for 6 years.
I think that that's probably the best result from a Hungarian men's figure skater for recent history anyway, for a long, long time. So everybody in Hungary will be very, very pleased to see that performance. A lot of triple jumps. He'll get the technical marks because he was out there doing a lot of work.
Looking to finish maybe in the top 12 or 13, finished the short program at 12, maybe even higher.
Yes, I think that he'll probably move up from that position. The technical merit mark is the what you do mark, and he did a lot of it. I'd like to see the men spinning a little bit better, and I think that that's something that Todd Eldridge has up his sleeve. He's a very, very good spinner.
Todd is in the next group. That is the final group, the gold medal group. And we've got one to go before we see the first of that final group. As the scores now come up for Zabol. Well, shrug of the shoulders, and what do you say?
Well, Sandy, I'm kind of shrugging my shoulders too, because I think that he put out quite a massive work there, although Michael Weiss did do a triple-triple combination, and they don't like it.
No,
they are.
Listen to that. They're not happy. And the trend continues. He's really not going to move too far away from 12th or 13th spot overall. However, the judges have made their decision in their wisdom, and it will stand. As we move on now to an 18-year-old from China, Zhenjin Gao. Very talented young man, whose choreography work is done by Kevin Cottam, good friend of Belinda's. Skating to the music by Fellini of Bralil Piwi.
Coming right up to open with triple axel. Will this be the quad?
Come on.
It certainly is. Quad toe, double toe. Lutz coming up, jumping machine this boy. And there it is again, beautiful running edge landing. Way to go yet in fully expressing the slow piece of this music, but 18 years of age. quad down, triple axle down. It's going to be a second quad. I don't think that was going to happen at all. Triple loop. Fabulous landing positions. Good landing, got it out. The spins are his weakness.
Cheeky little hello to the judges. A little too cheeky.
I think so. Very tired now. Quads and triple axles have taken it out of him. He'll have to find something for this last 40 seconds. He found a quad.
Very tired.
Not much left now.
What a performance. Zhenjin Gao of China, appropriately two quads. And it is appropriate because he was the first skater to land two quads in the same free skating competition. That was in the World Championships back in 1997. Great performance.
You wouldn't think an extra rotation on one or two jumps could take so much out of you, but it did indeed take it out of him.
This and is appeared the, to do the second one with ease.
I know. That's the triple axle. He was wanting to do a triple toe off that, but he was too far forward and racked up on the toe rake and he couldn't manage it. Here's the quad. One, two, three, four. Perfect. Into a double toe. Put the double toe on it so he'd be able to have another go at it later on. And that's the second quad. Just squeaked out that fourth revolution. And oh, look at that. He's so happy with that.
So he should be, because it was right near the end of his program. And as you called, he was feeling exhausted then, but he found something.
I thought he was getting ready for it coming in because you could see the chest go up and down and there's complete relaxation and try and make the jump. Spins are not good.
Well, then how do you think the judges will assess that performance?
Oh.
Don't be too harsh. What do you think?
What do I think? My gut instincts probably tell me 5.7 and then probably give him 5.3 for artistic to try and make the difference.
Now, he is the final skater in this third group. We'll be having a break and then coming out and watching the guns go for gold. And we're looking forward to that. So you may be staying up a little late, but stay with us because you're going to be seeing the best. Sunday, tomorrow anyway.
Exactly.
Still early.
Big night out. what do the judges do with this boy? The choreography and the expression is a little immature. The spins probably almost deductible because they're not making enough revolutions. Yet out he goes and he does a triple axel. He does two quads, one in combination. They have a dilemma on their hands.
Yeah, they've got him. He's got them thinking, hasn't he? Young man who trains at the Capital Gym in Beijing.
Absolute powerhouse jumping machine, a very economical rotator.
And didn't he make them look easy? That's the thing that I found so staggering.
The first one looked like a triple, didn't it?
Oh,
but I know you've been watching it. You were able to pick it.
Oh, just. To do that, four rotations in 0.7 of a second. I have enough trouble standing up in 0.7 of a second. It's incredible, isn't it? It's just the athleticism is quite extraordinary.
If he can develop his artistic side and get to work on the spins, it's scary to think what will happen in the next 4 years.
Well, it still leaves him behind Michael Weiss with those ranging from 5.4 to 5.7, whilst for presentation
he's got slammed on the artistic.
4.9,
absolutely slammed.
Gee. So there it is, Zheng Jingao of China. We'll take a break and then be back to open the door on gold. Who will it be? Stay with us right here.